I just had about the greatest moment accepting a delivery the other day. The driver comes out with a sheet of paper and says, "I've got a pallet of yarn here for you. Where should I put it?" And well, he wasn't wrong. When it gets cold outside, many of us reach for our favorite wool sweaters or mittens. And there's a reason for that. Sheep's wool is a fantastic insulator. So it's no surprise that it's gaining popularity as insulation for homes. Sheep's wool has some surprising features that makes it a healthy addition to the home and resistant to flame and moisture, but is it worth the extra investment? And how might it affect your health, wealth, and the planet? Let's find out. But before we dive in, throw us a like and hit that subscribe button to get more sustainable home improvement videos just like this one. So let's get started. So what is sheep's wool insulation? Well, it's exactly what it sounds like. Insulation that's made from real sheep's wool. Sheep in Iceland can withstand brutally cold winters thanks to their wool's unique properties. It's crimped and folded, forming millions of tiny little air pockets that create a thermal barrier against extreme hot or extreme cold. Now, sheep's wool insulation manufacturers build on that principle to create batts or rolls of insulation from individual wool fibers. Most industrial wool insulation is held together with polyester adhesive, but you can find products that are 100% natural. Sheep's wool insulation is often confused with the very different mineral wool insulation, which is made from fibers of molten basalt or iron ore. So what are the advantages of sheep wool? Well, if you were to touch a sheep that was outside during a rainstorm, you'd be amazed to find that their wool will feel nice and dry to the touch. Sheep's wool holds 33% of its weight in moisture without ever losing its insulating performance. Meanwhile, some other types of insulation are easily damaged when exposed to humidity or water. Now, this ability to absorb moisture means that sheep's wool can actually regulate a home's moisture levels. It can absorb excess moisture and even purify the air by pulling in harmful compounds that damage your air quality. So the main drawback of sheep's wool insulation is that it is more expensive than other insulation options. Sheep's wool insulation is still new to the market, and it's considered by some to be a sustainable novelty. Now, we see these sustainable features as major advantages that place sheep's wool as a premium insulation product. Now, when it comes to novel products like sheep's wool, we usually see prices drop as homeowners start discovering them and demanding them. The first question we always hear is sheep's wool a good insulator? Sheep's wool offers an R value of R 3.5 to 3.8 per inch, which is a bit higher than fiberglass, cellulose, and mineral wool insulation. Now compare this to vacuum insulated panels with R 45 per inch or polyurethane or phenolic foam at R 7 per inch. For homeowners in very cold climates, wool insulation batts can be used, but you might need to opt for slightly thicker walls for the best thermal performance. Now, since sheep's wool holds moisture, a lot of folks assume it's prone to mold and mildew. It makes sense if you think about it, but wool is full of surprises. When wool absorbs moisture from the air or a surrounding surface, it's actually stored inside the fiber where mold spores can't get to it. Moisture doesn't sit on the outside of the fibers, which is another reason sheep's wool will feel dry to the touch even after it's gotten wet. So sheep's wool seems like it's borderline magical when it comes to managing moisture, but what about common pests? It seems like a wall filled with soft wool would be a cozy home for insects or rodents. Now, when it comes to moths and insects, untreated sheep's wool can be an attractive home. That's why most sheep's wool insulation is treated with non-toxic and odorless solvents to keep those critters at bay. Now, check with your manufacturer to make sure that they only use additives that won't harm indoor air quality. And when it comes to rodents like mice and rats, wool is just as cozy as other soft insulation materials like fiberglass. Rodents want to nest somewhere dry and comfortable, so your best defense is always a well-sealed building envelope. Now, one look at a soft and dry bat of wool insulation might have fire alarms going off in your head, but wool just won't give up. Wool has naturally high nitrogen and water content, so it needs high levels of oxygen to burn. When wool heats up and combusts, its cell membrane structure swells, forming an insulating layer that prevents flame spread. Most sheep's wool insulation products meet a Class A building code for flame spread and smoke development, putting it at the front of the pack along with cellulose, mineral wool, and fiberglass insulation. Now for our favorite question, is sheep's wool insulation sustainable? Well, here at Rise, we're always on the lookout for home building products that help homeowners live lighter on the planet in terms of carbon emissions and impact on the biosphere. Now, in terms of its manufacturing process, sheep's wool boasts one of the least energy intensive processes among insulation products. It's a natural material that goes through limited processing outside of spinning, bonding, and some chemical treatment to make it resistant to critters. Some manufacturers claim that wool's embodied energy is less than half of cellulose insulation, which is already really low. Since sheep's wool insulation is still relatively new to North America, the material might have to travel long distances to reach a home. This does add to the embodied energy of sheep's wool, so just be mindful of where the raw material is coming from and your distance from the manufacturer. Now, a very common concern we hear from homeowners who first learn about sheep's wool insulation is, are sheep harmed in the harvesting process? Now, if you're anything like me, the thought of a sheep being harmed to help build your home, it's an absolute no-go. That's why you want to choose a manufacturer that takes animal welfare practices very seriously. So most nations, like the common wool exporter New Zealand, have a ban on a harmful practice called mulesing. Responsible sheep farming is more than possible and pretty common nowadays, so don't be afraid to do some careful research on where your manufacturer gets their wool. So I actually happen to have some sheep's wool bat insulation on hand, so I thought it would be a good opportunity to talk a little bit about how it's installed, since it's a much newer product to market. Now, a couple of things on that first. Like we mentioned earlier, there are really two types of sheep's wool bat insulation. One that's made with a mix of wool and polyfibers, and the other which is made with 100% wool, just like this one. Now, if you get the mix of wool and polyfibers, just make sure you find out where and what those fibers are really made from. Several manufacturers do take the opportunity to use recycled polyester instead of using virgin materials in their blends. Now, the composition of the bat is important because it also will dictate how it's installed. Wool and poly mixes will typically have the friction fit insulation that we're used to with other bats like fiberglass and mineral wool. But if you're opting for a 100% wool product like this one, you will need to install it a bit differently, which I'll show in just a minute. Now, before I get into that, can I point out the obvious with this install? I'm not using any protective equipment, and I've got to say that feels pretty darn good and kind of liberating when you think about it. I wouldn't even feel bad getting my 6-year-old daughter to help me install it. That's just how safe this stuff really is. It's nature in your walls.
I think we got it.
Good job. Nice work, y'all.
And I don't know how else to explain that it's just such a departure from what we're used to with insulation products, where some products like spray foam, you need full respiratory protection, and other bat products where you need a mask, safety glasses, and gloves at a minimum. I've got to say, it feels really good to have the peace of mind that comes with a product like this. So these particular bats do need a few staples to stay in place, and that's really all that's needed. Getting around wiring or boxes is easy to solve, and I find the layers of wool in these bats actually separate in a much cleaner way than fiberglass or mineral wool. So it's pretty flexible to work with. Now, I know some builders might say that it could take longer to install these types of bats, and they might be right. But our experience with it is that it's much more flexible and friendly to play with, and we also believe that prioritizing the health of the installers and their comfort when installing products like this is just as important as in any additional time it might take to throw in a few staples. So there you have it, folks. This concludes our video on sheep's wool bat insulation. Did we miss anything? Or maybe you have some experience with sheep's wool that you'd like to share? Please let us know in the comments below. And as always, find more sustainable home improvement tips and research at buildwithrise.com. Thanks, guys, and we'll catch you on the next one. Thanks so much for tuning in, guys. For more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe by clicking the button below. And also check out buildwithrise.com, the only place to turn any home improvement project into a sustainable one.